Welcome back to Frugal Mama. Today we're making cake, but not any cake. It's devil's cake. And no, it's not a cake mix. It's made from scratch. And as I said before, I love Christmas. So in 2013, when I moved back to my country, Canada, I went to a dollar store and I was amazed at things you guys can find over there in Canada and US. I've been to the US a lot of times when I was little. Got this bowl. Can you imagine just for $1, like a Canadian dollar? But enough of that. That's a whole new story, and it's a big story, and there's no way to make it small. Today we're gonna make not cake box mix. I don't know. First of all, I can't find it here. If you can find it, and it's cheap, good for you, go grab one. But what happens if you can't find one? Or you wanna make something delicious and moist? In Greece, we cannot find devil's cake, so we make our own. Are you ready to cook with me? Because now we're gonna make devil's cake in a Christmas bowl. And I'm wearing my Christmas apron with Santa. I love Christmas. As we continue till Christmas, you'll see me go Christmas nutty. Is that even a word? I love Christmas. So, just to get the best frugal, cheap recipes on the internet, and you're gonna make them yourselves, try them, and love them. Don't forget to subscribe. Yeah, the button's right here. I hope. Where am I showing? Or is it here? Anyways, it's right there. Showing both, just to make sure. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video so I can continue making more frugal recipes. How cheap? The cheapest. If you make them for Christmas, dinner, lunch, your guests and your family are gonna be going, get up, make me some more. And they're like really fast recipes. I'm a mom of three. I don't have time to be cooking like Martha Stewart. Why I say Martha Stewart? That's what a friend of mine calls me. She's like, you're the Martha Stewart of Yaltra, Greece. And I'm like, okay. She's from Canada too. But that's enough about me. Cooking time. I'm up and we're cooking. Are you ready? Because I'm filming this by myself. Here's a bowl. Putting it right down. And let me just get up. And we'll start putting our ingredients. Which of course, let me just get this here. Of course, I'll be writing them down in the description area so you can make this yourself. Here we go. You know that I have a cookbook that I've been writing for about 10 years, like finding amazing recipes and writing them down. So I'm double checking because I'm only human. I could forget something. First, you need a cup. This is my cup. It says 2 cups flour. I use store brand self-rising flour. Why store brand? Because it's tested for me, our store brand, and it's just flour. It's a staple. If you can get cheapest, it's the best. We'll just open it because I didn't open it before. And here we go. Our flour, 2 cups. We measure them. And try not to make a big mess. 1 cup down. Second cup. This is like a 500 gram flour. And there's more left. As you can see, we didn't use a lot. flowers out of the way. Second, teaspoon of salt. We need salt. Yeah, I buy it in bulk. 1 teaspoon of salt, and right in it goes. If I only had help with a friend or someone who can help me film this, that would have been amazing. But now we need 1 teaspoon baking powder. No, it's not store brand, but I got it cheaper. So, our store brand was in little envelopes, like little packs. But getting it in a can, because I do a lot of cooking, is a lot cheaper. So, 1 teaspoon baking powder. Closing everything. Now we need, soda. Yeah, it's soda. I buy it in bulk, so 2 teaspoons of soda, baking soda. And we're continuing. Unsweetened cocoa powder. Can you imagine I got this cheaper? Because I had a 50 cent sticker on it. Just taking care and searching for your ingredients sometimes actually helps you save money. The scissors, I could open it. And we need 3/4 of a cup. Here it is. Whoops. Three fourths of a cup. In it goes. As you can see, I'm not making a mess. I'm just using the same cup for all my dry ingredients. Yeah, it's Christmas. It's a Christmas coffee cup, which I got from the coffee, which I was using, which I drink. I'm a coffee person. I love coffee. Everybody knows that, or whoever knows me. Now we need sugar. Yep, I think it's right here. It said sugar. And we're gonna be using 2 cups of sugar. 2 cups. So we're using the same cup again and again. So when it's time to wash up, there's nothing to wash up. Yep, 2 cups. And the second one is in. And we continue on to... It says so vanilla. If you have, you put some vanilla. I don't, so I'm not putting any vanilla. Now, to get a moist devil's cake and get that chocolatey flavor, the secret is coffee. Now, because I have instant coffee, I'll use this. If you don't have instant coffee, because I know in the US and Canada, most people drink that coffee that you have in the pot. Just add 1 cup of that and skip the water. I'm just going to add this. If you have instant coffee, it becomes better. I don't know why. So 1/2 teaspoons of coffee. I love coffee everywhere. double checking my dry ingredients. They're all in. Just give it a nice little shake. Or get the spoon and mix them just a little bit up. Let's see if you can see this. We'll do it the other way around now. Right there. We'll figure this out. Just mix them up a little bit. Not too much, just a little bit. I don't know why I do that. I just like doing it. And you can start smelling the coffee and the chocolate. It smells amazing. I'll figure out how to do this next time. I hope. Yeah, so I'm mixed up and we're good. Now I'd like to do the wet ingredients. And we have, let me just get that up again. Perfect. Now we need hot coffee. It's like the step that I told you before. Since I added instant coffee, store brand. If you continue watching me, you'll probably go, yeah, we know that store in Greece. It's called Galaxias. It's store brand. I'm going to be adding some warm water. So let me just get in my cooler and get some warm water. And then back with warm water. Don't put too much hot water, just warm. If you don't have warm water, use cold water. It's the same thing. And in it goes. Now we're adding milk. Store brand milk. You can use any kind of milk you want. It could be 100%. This is 100% Greek, so that was really stupid of me. This is 3.5% fat. You can use any kind of milk. Buttermilk, whatever milk you have in your refrigerator, whatever milk you find at the stores that is cheap for cooking. Store brand is for cooking. I like it in my coffee, but it's for cooking for me. Just about to get this. A cup again. One cup. Voila. In it goes. Double checking everything. Now it says oil. I cook with olive oil. No, I don't buy this. This is from our olive trees. We have olive trees. So I'm using our oil because it's cheap. And, well, it's almost free. And the best part about it is, it's 100% organic. Let me just put the oil and explain. One cup. One cup oil. You can use margarine, like one cup margarine, one cup canola oil, whatever you have on hand, and whatever you like to put in your cakes. It's up to you. And the last thing we need are two eggs. From what I remember, these were really cheap in Canada and the US. But here, my mom has chickens in her backyard, so free-range eggs, they're free to me. I don't buy eggs. Okay, you don't have a mom that will give you eggs, but I do. In the sink, they go. Why the sink? So I'm going to be washing my one cup and one bowl at the end, and the mixer that I'm going to be using. So now we double check. Flour, got it. 2 cups flour, got it. 1 teaspoon salt. 1 teaspoon baking powder. Yeah, I'm reading my book. 2 teaspoons baking soda, 3/4 of a cup unsweetened cocoa butter powder, 2 cups sugar, 1 cup coffee. Well, you saw I just put 2 teaspoons of instant coffee with some warm water, but it wasn't that warm. It was kind of warm cold. The oil's in, the milk is in, eggs are in, didn't have vanilla, not putting vanilla today. And give me a second so I can move this over here and move you guys over with me today. I've charged my camera. It's amazing. And follow me into the kitchen. Yep, my kitchen. And of course, being the cheapskate I was, I didn't light up the lights. Again. Well, being frugal has its ups and its downs. This time, the down was, I don't like my lights until I actually need them. My oven is already preheating. It's almost ready. This is a fast cake. Like, if you get the hang of it, you could have it in the oven in less than 15 minutes, be out of the oven in 20, depends on your oven. And have it all nice and cooled. I usually do it during the nighttime, but it's too noisy in here with so many people. That's why I'm doing it today, where everybody is. Little one at school, husband, my middle son, picking olives, and I'm here cooking. Let's see if I can turn the camera down. Like, in the bowl. Can you guys see the bowl? Making some room. Yeah, I do have a lot of appliances. Now I'm using my hand mixer. Look at my nice apron. Christmas. And a Christmas bowl. Okay, I'm not going to open the hand mixer right away. Don't you hate it when you do that and everything just goes flying? And you have flour, sugar, cocoa all over the place. Just give it a swirl. Can't wait to make this and a few more desserts, which I'll be showing you in a couple of days for Christmas when my in-laws will be coming over. My mom, my in-laws. And I'll probably be making this for school. Are you ready? So sorry about the noise. It's hand mixer time. We have it on low at the beginning. Bye now. Getting a spoon. See the sides? I don't know if you can see them. There's flour stuck there. So just mix it around with a spoon. We don't want chunks anywhere. My mouth is watering. It's like, yum, yum, can't wait. Let me just get this pan out of the way. And we continue with the hand mixer on high. Sorry about that, but I'm hearing a noise behind me, and there's no one here, so I'm getting kind of... That could be my wood stove for heating, anyways. That's it. That's actually it. Yeah, I know. I wash my hands a lot while I'm cooking. I don't know why. Last mix with a spoon. But the trick is here. In my pan, I've added this paper. It's like a grease wax paper. So you don't have to oil the pan or nothing. Just dump it in here and you can wash it a lot faster. So here we go. And of course, the spoon fennel in. Let me just get that out. And get a new spoon. And wash my hands. Fine. Sorry about that. Now, new spoon, clean spoon. Fix the paper. This will actually not let that cake stick, because it is a sticky cake, trust me. It sticks to the bottom. Too fluffy and helps with washing after, like cleaning up. Yeah, you're seeing my Christmas bowl from Canada. Or do I miss Canada? If I had a job, I'm applying everywhere. Well, that's a whole new story. And I can't get a job around here. And no, it's not worth moving to another place to get a job. So here we are. Everything's in. Almost nothing got dirty. And sorry, putting it up. Now, as you saw, everything is in here, right? Now it's just gonna go in the oven. We'll let it bake. I have my oven. At 325, I was looking at the book because I'm checking, double checking, everything is perfect. And it's going to be cooking for at least 20 to 30 minutes. Just check it in between. Take a toothpick, insert it in the middle, take it out. If there's no cake, it's ready. Just let me put it in the oven. It's a nice preheated oven. And in it goes. And in 25 minutes, we're having, well, I'm not going to have it, it's going to be hot, it's going to be warm. We're having cake, moist devil cake made from scratch. Now icing, I don't put icing on my cake, but if you want icing, you can either make it or you can just go buy it. I like making my own when I do want to make icing, but I think just a cake, a nice moist cake is enough. So, see you in about a half an hour when the cake's gonna be out of the oven and cool down a little bit. And we're back right now and we're checking on our cake. Do you like my apron? Give me a thumbs up if you do. Anywhere. So, we open, we take our toothpick, we insert it, and it's clean. Now we take the cake out of the oven. Can you see this? Just put it down on the bottom of my fingers. And let me just take you over to my moist, juicy devil cake. Yeah, I think I'm in love with this cake. Something went wrong today, but that's a whole new story. And we're here. Yeah, it cracked. But when it gets cool, I'm gonna take it out with a pan. As you can see, you just pull this off. Just let it cool, because it's gonna break. Take it out of here, turn it over, and you can sprinkle. Is this side better? I'm gonna sprinkle, you can sprinkle some sugar, powdered sugar. You could put frosting, or whatever you like. I'm just gonna turn it over so the kids don't see that it's cracked on top. And that's it. Now we just leave it there to cool. No, just don't take it out of the pan. It's gonna break and crumble, and trust me, I've done it, I've tried it. Just leave it there. If you're making this in the evening, just leave it overnight and take it out in the morning. Just whip up some of that frosting that you buy in cans, and there's breakfast for the little ones, or a nice frugal, healthy snack idea for school. Well, I'm gonna leave it there for a couple of hours, like an hour or two, and you'll be here when I'll be cutting it again. So you can see the cake in actual cutting soon. Just be a little patient, just a little bit more patient so you can see the cake. And our devil cake is out. Yeah, there's a piece missing. See, I just turned it. It's very chocolatey. No, it's not burnt, it's chocolatey. Let me just get you, I just cut a piece out. It's already missing. I didn't have a plate or platter, and I'm not putting frosting, but you could just frost that. And it's here. Please focus. It's nice, soft, juicy. Let me see if I can get my fingers over there. Where are you? It's soft. It really is. And it's yummy. Yummy, 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 yummy. Triple yummy for me. And turning it this way.